neutral site action, and we're just about ready for kickoff. And now it's time for the coin toss, and it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Fans are on their feet awaiting the start of this game as the players line up for the kick. He just drills this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The quarterback brings his troops out of the field for the first drive of the game. Makes it to the 37.
Offensive lineman played that one perfectly, giving the tailback plenty of space to work with, and he took advantage of it.
First and 10, ball on their own 37. Runs it left for a decent game.
That makes it second and 6.
Himself and picked up a good-looking first down.
Great execution and a good decision there by the quarterback.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 48-yard line. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. And down he goes at about the 41. And he's tackled around the 33-yard line. That play is good for 8 yards and a first down.
Great look from the quarterback to find his receiver and make the quick throw for the new set of downs.
It was a great read by the quarterback there to take the snap and throw it quickly to get the first. He's at the 20, finds the freshman. Tackled at the 12-yard line.
Well, that's a big-time play there, and as a quarterback, you're willing to take certain chances with certain wide receivers. You're not going to put the ball into coverage like that very often, but if you have confidence and trust, and you've worked out a lot with that wide receiver, you know what his abilities are, and you know that you have confidence and he's going to be able to come down, regardless of putting it up in traffic, you're willing to take that chance, and that time, that's exactly what we saw.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 12. Receiver dropped it. Incomplete. This is the 8th play of this drive. He's on the run. They'll bring him down at the 8th. They're at the 8. It's 3rd down. Taken down at the 3. Nice gain, but not enough for the first down.
Yeah, that's a nice play there. They did everything right except get enough yards for the first down.
Brought down at the 1. Here's the 11th play of the drive. Touchdown, Cornhuskers.
That was a very good all-around effort. The running, the blocking, the entire package. A well-deserved score.
And he tacks on the extra point. An 11-play, 74-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
Sends it sailing downfield. He's tackled at the 21. The Cougars' offense basically predicated on what this kid can do.
The thing I love about this guy, Brad, is just the intangibles that he brings to the table. We've been seeing this guy make plays over the weeks, but the thing that I've really recognized is his ability to really lead this football team. When things are going well, he's patting everybody on the back. When things are not going well, he's trying to pick them back up and getting them ready to go. So not only does he physically have these tools, but also I really love the way he approaches the game.
Fires it out of bounds around the 37-yard line.
Gain of 3 yards. That makes it second and six.
Quick throw out to the receiver. He's tackled at the 43-yard line.
Good work here by the defense to keep him from making something more out of that play.
Steps out of bounds. Right around the 46-yard line.
Not a huge play, but an effective play nonetheless. Be able to pick up a first down. Again, this offense right now just making good decisions, moving the sticks, and maintaining possession of the football.
He steps up the 48-yard line. Under pressure, and he's level at the 42.
A great defensive end in college football just pins his ears back and has, again, that extra instinct to know when to jump the snap count, when to take a chance on third down. And it seems like they almost save their extra pass rush and extra incentive as far as their energy when it really matters on a third down, when they feel like they can beat that offensive tackle and get off the line of scrimmage a little bit quicker. And that's something that I think we've seen him do throughout this game.
Man can't tack on in the yardage. And he can't hang on to the ball.
Well, that's exactly what happens when you take your eyes off the ball. Concentration for return man is of the utmost importance.
The main thing is they got the ball back, and now they can go to work on offense. This offense did really well with the air attack on their last trip out there. Let's see if they can do the same thing here.
Well, it's one thing to have speed. It's another thing to have an idea of what you're doing and how to attack the defense. And right now, these wide receivers really have done an outstanding job in being able to make their reads and getting out of their breaks, and the quarterback put the ball right on the money.
From their own 26-yard line. Second down, Nebraska up 7 points. He's going to try and scramble, and they got him. Set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback. He gets hit out of bounds at about the 31. Gets to about the 44-yard line. You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. Fires that quickly to the tailback. He's knocked out of bounds around the 35-yard line.
You know, if you use him in this offense the right way, it's almost like you have an extra wide receiver. He's that good.
Taken down at the 25-yard line. After one, this game's still pretty close. The Cornhuskers with a touchdown lead. And we're back for more action here in quarter number two. And they make the stop around the 12-yard line. Zips it to his receiver. Touchdown. Here comes the kicker to try to tie this game up. And he converts the extra point. A four-play, 56-yard drive. And the result, 7 points. We're even at seven in this one. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He sends this one deep. And he's taken down at the 26. You always want to go in the locker room with momentum, so as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays. They'll line up with five wide receivers. Gets to about the 27-yard line. From their own 27-yard line, it's second down. He's scrambling. Tackle made around the 30-yard line. Scrambling around. He's to the 40. And now the ball is loose. That's a big break for this defense.
You know, this offense just can't afford to be getting hit with the turnover bug. They need to hold on to the football.
This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. And they've got all their DBs in there to match up against the five-wide set. Once and all, going deep. Big catch there as they knock it out of bounds. To his receiver, and down he goes just outside the goal line.
I think it was a great play call, and it was very well executed. Any coach would be happy with that kind of outcome on a first or second down play.
Touchdown, Cougars. Makes the PAT. Looks like they're ready for the kick. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. From the 50, first down. That's a great tackle at the 42-yard line. Now he's scrambling, diving for extra yardage. 37-yard line. It's first down. At the 20, inside the 10, and he's finally brought down at the 7. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Tries to buy some time, and he's tackled at the 5-yard line. Extra point to tie this game up. And he adds the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. Excellent kick. He's to the 20. He gets out to about the 22-yard line. Their last drive ended with a touchdown. Let's see what happens on this possession.
And it was a really nice drive, too, Brad. The quarterback got into a nice rhythm and did a good job of picking apart the defense.
And he throws it away. From their own 22-yard line, it's second down. A quarterback in the gun with 5 receivers. And he is drilled at the 34-yard line. They come out in an empty backfield. Going long. Keeps his eye on it, makes the catch. Tackled at the 20-yard line. Slings it, and he hits him hard at the 6-yard line.
The receiver was pretty much blanketed, but when you have as accurate an arm as this young man, you can get away with riskier passes sometimes.
Fires quickly, touchdown! Hits the PAT. So a 5-play, 79-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Brad, how about the guys up front? The offensive line giving the quarterback plenty of time to be able to read the defense and make the right throw.
He's to the 20, and he's tackled at the 24.
Brad, this is my kind of game. I love seeing this kind of production and the way these quarterbacks are playing. Both teams are challenging both of these defenses.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. He scrambled. Now he's going to run and watch out. Slides down. So the quarterback scrambles for about 8 yards. It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. He's on the run. They'll bring him down at the 36. quick throw, and he's taken down at the 40.
Nebraska is going to have to use their second time out of the half.
From their own 40-yard line, second down. Going deep. He stays in bounds, and he hauls in a big one.
I think that one's on the offensive line. They've got to do a better job of holding their blocks, or else this quarterback's going to be pulling turf out of his face mask all game.
He's going to try and scramble. Decides to slide. There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. Going to try a long field goal here. It's up, looks long enough, and he just drilled it from long range. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Nice kick, plenty of distance. He's to the 20. He's tackled at the 25.
Not sure what the flag is about here. Let's go down to the field and find out.
Clip it. Receiving team. Still first down.
And here comes the offense again. They'll try to make it two touchdowns and two possessions.
So much of the passing game is about the timing between the quarterback and his wide receivers. Right now with this offense, they are in sync, and really the timing and execution is flawless.
Great first half of action, and we're hoping for more of the same. Houston's up by four.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Bruce Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes.
You know who I feel sorry for in that first half?
Who?
The poor production assistant on SportsCenter who's going to try to sift through all of those highlights and come out with the ones he's going to choose to try to make the SportsCenter top 10.
Da-da-da, da-da-da. No, there's definitely a lot to choose from, but that's what you like as a fan. I think the fan, they like that and enjoy that more than they like seeing great defense. They like seeing guys go up and make huge one-handed stabs and guys make big, long diving touchdown runs, and they like all that. So they like watching guys hurdle over guys. You see it all the time. So I think the kids know that too, and they're trying to do their best to always, you know, make a huge play and make a big explosive play and put a little cherry on top of that play so that they can be maybe on one of those ESPN top plays.
We've done what we can do here at halftime. Time to get you back out to the second half. We'll keep an eye on everything going on in college football. Brad Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit ready with a call.
Boy, I hope the second half's as good as the first. Just about set to start the third quarter in a tight one. It's fielded at the 2. Tackle at the 21. The offense is on its way out on the field again, and they haven't had any problem finding the end zone in their past couple of drives. Houston is up 4. Sets up a screen. Tailback's got it. Brought down around the 20-yard line. Screen pass. He's got his halfback. Knocked out of bounds at the 35-yard line. A little toss across the middle. He's tackled around the 47-yard line. Second and 13 coming up here. Ball on the 43-yard line. Nice run, and he's brought down. So they get 5 yards there on the halfback draw. Steps up in the pocket. It's on the ground. Scoops up the loose ball. He's taken down at the 49. Houston is up by 4. Oh, excellent punt. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. Houston's coaches just got to be happy. I'd love to coach a kid like this.
Oh, I think these coaches love to coach a guy like this, and another great performance by him individually and for this offense.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. He's scrambling. And they make the stop at the 27-yard line. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Scrambling around. Slides down to the ground.
Frustrated there. They did everything. They got to the quarterback. In fact, it looked like they had a chance to bring him down for the sack, and somehow he's able to throw the ball away.
From their own 36-yard line, second down. Good open field tackle. Carries the ball for a nice game. From their own 47-yard line. First down. The pitch, and he's got some room. And he's level at the 45-yard line.
Execution on that short pass play.
When you've got a quarterback making throws that quickly, the defense doesn't have a lot of time to react to the play. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 40. Slides down. We're at play number 9 of this current drive. There he goes. Nice run there. So the option keeper will get him a first down.
It's a very well-executed option play. The blocking was there, and the quarterback made the correct decision to keep it himself and get the first down.
Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun. Five wide receivers. He's out of bounds at the 30.
He was never able to get ahead of steam on that carry.
From the 30-yard line, it's second down. He makes his way to about the 22. We're at the 12th play of the drive. Now we'll see how the backup can do after that injury. Out of bounds at the 19-yard line. Looks like they're going to go for it on fourth down. The Cornhuskers quarterback down on the sideline after getting injured earlier. I think it looks like he's in that much pain, and I would bet that we're going to see him back in the game before the game's over. Up the middle for a nice game. Here's play number 14 of this drive. And down he goes at the 14-yard line.
He knew it was a run all the way. Got a good jump. Once he got there, he wasn't about to let him slip away either.
One quarter to go, and this looks like it could come down to the very end. 21-17, Cougars. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number four. He fights forward to about the 13. It's third and long, and at this stage of this game, they probably have to go to the air. Five wide.
Smart, heady play by that defender. That was solid fundamental pass defense.
He gets it up, and it's good. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. A score here might effectively end this one. Houston is up one. Fires across the middle. And he's tackled at the 45. It out and it falls incomplete. From their own 45-yard line, second down. Throws complete and he's hit hard behind the line.
Best example, but I'm going to tell you something. This young man is really getting better at running his routes, which is a truly underrated quality these days.
And it's caught, and he's brought down quickly.
Yeah.
bring him down behind the line. Third down, and they need to get it down to the 32. Houston with a one-point lead. They'll make the sack. It looks like the defensive end that got in there.
Yes, it was. He did a wonderful job of fighting off blocks to bring the quarterback down.
In the shotgun and five wideouts. Steps out around the 36-yard line. This is a pretty crucial series right here. With things being so tight, your best players have to step it up on both sides of the ball. Throws complete, big loss. They lose four there.
That play was sort of out of sync from the start, but you have to also recognize that the defense made a great play. They read it from the get-go.
Second down, 14 coming up here. Ball on the 32.
Not that impressive of a play. Let's see if they continue to employ the short passing game or if they decide to run the ball.
Like they've decided to go for it here. Just under 2 minutes in the game. Complete. He's got room. Tackle right around the 46-yard line. Tight end incomplete. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on their own 46. Hand off up the middle. They'll bring him down around the 49-yard line. And they get stopped after a short gain.
Yeah, the quarterback better get these guys to the line of scrimmage and hurry up. Just getting past the first down marker, but picking up some major yards on the play.
This is the eighth play of this drive. To the halfback on the screen. And he shoved out of bounds around the 9-yard line.
The quarterback dumped it off, and everyone did a good job of blocking up front. Doesn't get much better than that.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Under a minute left in the game. They get nice yardage on that run. This is the 10th play of this drive. And they're looking to get 2 points here. He's got it for two. A 10-play, 65-yard drive, and they add 8 points to their total. Here we go. They'll need lightning to strike on this return. Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 20. He gets out to about the 22-yard line. And so that's going to do it. The Cornhuskers come out on top, 28-21. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.